All right, welcome everybody. This is the Friday night yoga for the people, and Friday nights are all about release and stretch and nothing too crazy. I mean, we will do some movement, a little bit of engagement, but if you're looking for something that is go get them, that's what my Sunday classes are. And then my Wednesday classes are yin, which is meditative deep stretch where we're working with the connective tissue and the joints. So we will be working with muscles tonight. And our focus tonight is the IT band, also known as iliotibial band. Iliotibial band because it starts at your iliac crest and runs all the way down the outside of your thigh, crosses your knee, and attaches to the top of your shin bone, which is your tibia. So oftentimes this area on folks can it's a band of fascial tissue, so it is connective tissue. But it can get knotted up, it can get sticky, and the IT band along with the piriformis, which is a back of the hip, across the hip muscle, those two areas together are usually culprits for sciatica if we don't keep them supple and keep the blood flow to them. Then we end up with quite a bit of pain going anywhere from the low back all the way down to the leg and foot. So that's what tonight's postures are going to be focused on, is helping you release that area through stretch and engagement of the back, hip, and leg muscles. So let me read my disclaimer before we get going. Basically, it says I'm not responsible for anything. Please don't sue me. Disclaimer, please consult with your physician before beginning any exercise program. By participating in this exercise or exercise program, you agree that you do so at your own risk, are voluntarily participating in these activities, and assume all risk of injury to yourself, and agree to release and discharge in the hills or Libby Gore from any and all claims of action, known or unknown, arising out of in the hills or Libby Gore's negligence. I would never want to be negligent. But for legal purposes, there's my disclaimer. Let's start with a little bit of centering here. So just coming to your comfortable seated position. Maybe you have a bolster or a pillow you can elevate your hips on. Also, a block can be nice for that as well. And what the elevating the hips does is it just kind of relaxes the hips open, especially if you come into the seat and the knees are really high up, or you're dumping into your low back. That's an exaggeration, but you get it. You get what I mean here. This just helps to release and open that area for you. So go ahead and come into your comfortable seat, closing your eyes. Coming into the rhythm of your breath. Relaxing the muscles of your face, your jaw, shoulders release as there is a slight lift in heart center. Just observing, taking note of any obvious areas of tension, stress, or strain that you can begin to release upon the exhale.
and we'll make it our intention to be present with our practice, using our breath as an anchor into the present moment, breath by breath, moment by moment. We'll bring our hands together at heart center. And we'll inhale, reaching forward and up. And exhale, drawing back down to the heart, holding here to open our class with three ohms, taking an inhale. Resonates within the heart space. All right, we're going to come onto our backs to begin with for the active version of Astha Paddha Hastasana. If you have your strap or something that you can utilize as a strap, you'll need it now. So either a scarf, a belt, or a strap. And the ladies that are joining me live, do y'all have that with you right now? I forgot, you turned your microphone.
I was muted, yes.
Okay, yes you do. You can give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down, Anna. Thumbs down, okay. Can you go grab yourself either a necktie or a scarf or something that you can use, or if you have your strap? I don't want you to miss out on this goodness. And Judy, you're familiar. We're going to do the gas heel version of Padangasana.
Yes, yes. I'll go back on to mute. Thanks.
Okay, thank you. I'll get going as soon as I see Anna back with us.
And I'm decent, so I'll try to do the audio, the video now. Well, I don't know about decent, but anyway. Oh, there I am. Okay.
Okay, so while we're waiting on Anna to get back with us, all you're going to need for this first part is a strap. And this is just to give us some resistance. There's Anna. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get going. You'll come down onto your back and start with both feet on the mat, knees bent. You're going to take your strap and bring it around the ball of your right foot, and then open the sole up, or extend your leg up so that the sole is open to the ceiling, and then bring the bend back into your extended leg. So I started by lengthening, and now I'm gonna bend back in, and this is where we're gonna begin. And we're gonna dynamically move and engage muscles of our legs while we're holding this position. So the positions that we're gonna toggle between, I call it gas, as if you're pressing on the gas pedal through the ball of the foot, and heel. So that's pushing through your heel and flexing back strongly. So it's gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel. We're gonna do 10. Gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel, two more, gas, heel, gas, heel. Hold here, take an inhale. Exhale, lengthen the leg all the way up to the ceiling. Same movements, 10 gas heels. And gas, heel, 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 three more, gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel. I can't remember if that's two or three. One more, gas, heel, just for good measure. All right, so now you're going to bring your leg into external rotation. I used to prompt my students to wrap the strap around their leg, but it doesn't really help that much and it becomes confusing. So what you wanna do is just turn your toes out and your heel is facing the midline. So heel out, or toes out, heels in. Same movements here. Gas, heel, holding that external rotation. Gas, heel, 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 three more, gas, heel, gas, heel, and gas, heel. Okay, just the opposite. We're gonna come into internal rotation. So your toes are gonna wrap in toward the midline of your body. Your heel is now pointing outward. Now the leg is still directly over my hip. So I'm not opening out or pulling across. I'm just rotating my thigh bone in its socket to turn my foot in right now, pigeon-toed basically. And gas, heel, woo, gas, heel, 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 and gas, heel. I feel like I miscounted on that one, but oh well. All right, so we're gonna come back to center with our leg. You're gonna, it may help to do a loopy around your hand so that you don't have to white knuckle to hold the strap. You're going to lengthen your left leg out on the mat. You'll externally rotate the foot again so that your toes are pointing out, your heel is pointing in, bring a bend back into your knee. And you're on your exhale, you're gonna open right. Don't let your left hip pop up off the mat though. Keep it grounded. You can even use your left hand to press down into that hip. My knee is strongly bent here. Gas, heel. Gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel, three more, gas, heel, gas, heel, and gas, heel. Take an inhale, exhale, extend the leg fully. And gas, heel, 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 three more, gas, heel, gas, heel, and gas, heel. Inhale, drawing all the way up. You're gonna switch over to your left hand with your strap. Internally rotate, so toes in, heels out, bring a bend into the knee, and come across the body to the left. Don't let this right hip roll up and over. You want to keep it grounded and just let the leg stretch across. Bend in the knee to start with, and gas, heel, 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 gas, heel. Three more. Gas, heel, gas, heel, and gas, heel. Take an inhale. Exhale, extend the leg fully across the body, trying your best to keep that internal rotation and your right hip grounded, and gas, heel, 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 three more, gas, heel, gas, heel, and gas, heel, inhale all the way up, and we'll exhale and use our strap to float our extended leg all the way down to the mat. Just observe for a moment before we move into the other leg. And I don't know if y'all can hear it, but the frogs just started singing out there. All right, go ahead and slip your left leg into, or left foot into the strap. Start with your right knee bent, and we'll draw the left leg up over the hip, but then bring a bend into the knee to start with. Sole of the foot is open to the ceiling. And gas, heel, 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 and gas, heel. Take an inhale. Exhale, extend all the way up to the ceiling. And gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel. Gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel, gas, heel, three more, gas, heel, gas, heel, and gas, heel. All right, staying in the center here, we're going to come into external rotation. So you're going to rotate your toes to point open, heel in. So toes out, heels in. And gas, heel, 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 three more, gas, heel, gas, heel, and gas, heel. Let's switch to internal rotation. Toes in, heel out, still over the hip though. And gas, heel, 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 three more, gas, heel, gas, heel, and gas, Peel, unwind the leg, bring your strap over into the left hand if it's not already there. You're going to externally rotate. You'll lengthen out through the right leg on the mat, and you can use your right hand to help keep that hip grounded. You'll bring a bend into the knee to start with. Deep inhale, exhale, opening left, and gas, heel, 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 three more, gas, heel, gas, heel, and gas, heel. Take an inhale, exhale, fully extend the leg to the left, and gas, heel, 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 two more, gas, heel, and gas, heel, inhale, drawing up, we're in the home stretch, no pun intended, bend the knee again, you're going to internally rotate, heel out, toes in, and you'll exhale coming across the body to the right. Leave your left hip grounded though. Don't let it come up and go with you. And gas, heel, 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 three more, gas, heel, gas, heel, and gas, heel. Take an inhale, exhale, fully extend the leg across the body. Oh, this is the one that gets me so bad. And gas, heel, 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 three more, gas, heel, gas, heel, and gas, heel, inhale up, and exhale, float the leg down. Oh, we made it. Should feel good. It's a lot of work to make it through those, that set of postures, but so worth it. So very worth it. All right, you're gonna help yourself up and over onto hands and knees. You can just put your strap off to the side. I'm looking and I don't think, no, we won't need the strap anymore, but you will need blocks or something that can lengthen your arms if you have them. If not, we can work around it, but later on. Okay, so we're gonna come onto hands and knees, just in a tabletop neutral spine position here. So make sure that hands are slightly forward, slightly wider than the shoulders. Fingers are spread nice and wide. And we wanna set our hands to take some of this pressure out of our wrists. So to do that, you'll come up onto your fingertips and then you'll press all the way down through your fingers and into your knuckles and the rest of your palm, and that should take a little bit out of your wrists for you. Hopefully it does. Here, we're going to come with our right leg straight out from our hip. And I'm on the inside arch of my foot, and we're gonna cat-cow breathe with the leg open here. So, We'll draw our navels up to our spines. On the inhale, we'll reach our heart forward, up and open. Tailbone reaches back and up so that the crown moves toward the tailbone. On the exhale, we'll reverse everything by tucking under with our pelvis, tucking under with our chin, pressing the back side of the heart up to the ceiling. Inhaling, open. Pull the shoulders back and in toward the spine. Exhale, tuck. Inhale and exhale and inhale and exhale and inhale and exhale and inhale and exhale. Two more. Inhale and exhale. And inhale and exhale. And then let's inhale back to neutral. We'll draw our leg back in, but reach it back behind us now. And just kind of press and bounce into your heel back there. You should feel that opening up your calf muscles when you do that. So just a little bounce into the calf there. And then we're gonna come to center and inhale the right leg straight back and up hip height. I'm pressing through the heel. I'm going to cross over to the left, to the outside of my mat, and plant my toes down. I'm going to look over my left shoulder, press into my right hip, and look at my toes, my right toes that are out to the left side of my mat. And I'm just breathing here. Take three more breaths. And then I'm going to inhale, coming back to center, and exhale, bring my knee back down into starting position for fire hydrants. So we're not going to do the full kick in the fire hydrant. We're just going to open out to the side and come back down. Let me show you this from the front. What I don't want you doing when you raise your leg up, I don't want you sending all your weight over to the left. That's taking the work out of your hip. So what you want to stay in center and just let the hip do the work for you. Okay? So we're here in center, we're still on the right leg. We're gonna inhale and lift the leg out to the side. You can imagine why these are called fire hydrants. And then exhale back down. Inhale out and up. Exhale down, trying to stay centered. Inhale out and up. Exhale down. Inhale out and up. Exhale down. Inhale out and up. That's six. Exhale down. Inhale, seven. Exhale down. Inhale, eight. Exhale down. Inhale, nine. Exhale down. Inhale, 10. Exhale down. One more thing, no, two more things on the right side before we go back and get all this on the left. Donkey kicks. So you're gonna reach that leg back, keeping the 90 degree bend in it so that the sole of your foot is open to the ceiling. And it's a pulsing motion. But I first want you to draw your navel up, and then you're gonna pulse. Pulse up to the ceiling. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. release down. Step your left knee into the center line of your body, so along your midline. You're gonna step your right knee across into the front. So let me show you that from the front. So I stepped my left knee into center. That's my left. I know it looks like my right on the camera, but my right is gonna come in front and cross. And then I'm gonna open my shins out as far as I can and sit my bum back between my heels. Do y'all need to see that again? I see y'all both like looking at the cameras going, what? Let me go through it again. So I started here, just in table. I'm gonna step my left knee into the center. Actually, it'll probably be easier to do it the other way and step behind instead of forward. So step your right knee into the center, do over, right knee into the center. Ooh, I see it, Judy, yay. And then cross your left knee behind to plant. Open your shins out, and then you're gonna walk yourself back to sit between your heels. You should be feeling the treatment in that right ham hock area. Yes, I see Judy. I said ham hock. In the Gore house, this is actually known as pork chops right there. So you're going to feel it in the pork chops. Anna, give me a thumbs up if you got it. Okay, good. I couldn't see your lower body. Okay, cool. Now I can. So we're just breathing into that hip. This is a version of cow face position. It's just a different way of coming into it. We're not doing the arm portion of cow face, gomukhasana. But it's just a nice stretch of the IT band area. And I'm also feeling so hammy getting it in there. Getting it. All right. So now we're going to come up and do all of that again on the left side. So, help yourself up, and I'm gonna try, I'm watching the time, Anna, because I know you have to leave at 7. And so, I'm gonna try to time it where we're not in the middle of something for you, so.
That's okay.
All right. So, coming back into center, back into your tabletop position here, we're gonna start with that cat-cow breathing. Actually, I'll turn the other way so y'all can see my leg here. So we're gonna reach open with the left leg. I'm on the inside edge of the foot. I draw my navel up toward my spine to protect my low back. And we inhale and come into our arched, concave, arched back. Crown toward the tailbone, and we exhale, convex. Inhaling, open. Exhale, tucking and really pressing the back side of the heart up to the ceiling. Inhale, heart moves forward, up and open. Exhale, back side of the heart moves up and open. Inhale, front body expansion. Exhale, back body expansion. We'll take 3 more of those breaths. Last one. And then I'm gonna inhale back to neutral, step straight back through the leg now so that I'm on my toes, and I'm just gonna kind of bounce into my heel back there. Should feel good, like a good stretch through the calf. I forgot to set my hands and I could feel it in my wrist. If you need to set your hands, do so. All right, now you're gonna inhale the leg up, hip height, cross over to the right side of your mat or outside of your mat. Press into your left hip and then look over your right shoulder towards your left foot. Five breaths. Then we'll inhale back to center. Exhale down. Reset our hands for fire hydrants. We're gonna do 10 of these. Again, I'll remind you, try not to lean off to the opposite side. Try to stay right here in center and just let the hip do the work for you. Okay. Inhale, out and up. Exhale down. Inhale two. Exhale down. Inhale three. Exhale down. Inhale four. Exhale down. Inhale five. Exhale down. Inhale six. Exhale down. Inhale seven. Exhale down. Inhale eight. Exhale down. Inhale nine. Exhale down. Inhale 10. Exhale down. Come straight up for donkey kicks. And pulse. One, two, three. Keep your navel lifted. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Come back down. This time, left knee is going to be in front. So, you're going to step your left knee into center. Step your right knee behind. Open your shins out. And then scoot yourself back to sit between your heels. And you can stay folded. The more folded you are over the legs, the deeper this is going to be for you. So if you need to back out of it a little bit, you may want to sit up some. And we breathe here. You got it, Judy, yay. So we're just catching our breath from all those fire hydrants and donkey kicks here. A productive breath catching. All right. So you're gonna crawl yourself forward out of this. And come back onto hands and knees here. Toes turned under. Navel drawn up toward the spine. Fingers spread nice and wide, slightly forward, slightly wider than the shoulders. You can set your hands. Take an inhale into your low back. And exhale, press back and up to downward facing dog. Now, I'm going to show you this from the front view. Where I don't want your shoulders is here. Using your shoulders as earrings, this is no good. I want you broadened across your upper back, pressing the front of your mat away. There should be a feeling of an outward spiral of the upper arms and an inward spiral of your forearms. So another thing I'd like for you to do is engage your navel and your low ribs up towards your spine. And then you can have the feeling that you're trying to engage the tops of your feet towards your shins. That will engage tibialis, which is a muscle, the shin muscle. And it will help release your calf muscles. So your heels will start to release toward the mat. Now take a strong pigeon toe here. Internal rotation. Heels out, toes in. We'll have three more breaths here. From here, we're going to crisscross walk up to our hands. So you're going to step the left foot across to the right, and you'll cross over with the right, walking crisscrossed all the way up to your hands. And then when you get up to your forward fold position, feet can come hips distance apart. And we'll inhale, taking a soft bend in the knees, pressing through the soles of our feet to come out and up. And exhale, hands to the heart. And I can see that I am cut off, so I'm going to move my camera, well, my laptop, really, back so that hopefully it will, it is still cutting me off. Here we go. And I don't think I need to be so far away now that I moved. Yay, there I am. All right. So if you have blocks, this is where you'll want to grab your blocks. And we'll just bring our blocks forward so that they're in arm's reach for us, but we don't need them quite yet. Anna, do you have blocks, thumbs up or thumbs down? Actually, I can't see.
Thumbs up or thumbs down? Thumbs down, okay.
No problem, I'll lead you through without and with, because Judy, I know you have blocks, so. All right, so from here, we're gonna come into a half forward fold that is focused on opening the hamstrings. And so I'll show you this from the side. What I'd like for you to do is bring your hands to the tops of your thighs, open your shoulders so that they're not hunched forward. You're gonna press into your thighs, take a deep inhale tall through your crown, take a soft bend in your knees, and then slide down just above your knees, and you're pressing back on your thighs. I'm reaching my sit bones up to the ceiling, just like I would with a cat back. So it's an anterior tilt of my pelvis, really trying to get length in the hamstrings. And we breathe. And I'm looking straight down at the mat, reaching the crown of my head in the opposite direction of my tailbone. So I've got a long back of the neck, my heart is reaching forward, and my tailbone is reaching back and up. And we're breathing. Three more breaths here. And then we'll inhale and hinge back up to standing. Okay, so Judy, you can go ahead and grab your blocks. Anna, no worries. So what I want for you to do, I'll get Judy into the posture and then I'll come back and show you what it looks like without the blocks, Anna. So what I want for you to do is cross your right leg over your left. Take a deep inhale, Judy, tall. And then Judy, you're just gonna hinge at your hips and come down into a fold using your blocks. Anna, here's what we're gonna do. You're gonna bring your hands back to your thighs. Take a deep inhale, tall, and you're gonna exhale and hinge forward and slide down your legs as far as you can. And if you can reach the mat, you can use the mat. The blocks are just to make your arms longer with this one. If you cannot reach the mat, Anna, I want you pushing into your legs. I want you pushing into something, because if you're not pushing into something, your hamstrings think you're about to fall over. And so they'll seize up and they will not stretch well for you. So we're breathing here. Make sure you're not squeezing your shoulders up around your ears. We have two more breaths here in the center. All right, inhale, go long through your spine. Judy, you're gonna travel over to the right with your block so that it looks like this. Anna, you're going to take an inhale long with me, and you're just gonna crawl yourself around your legs. Remember, I want you pushing into something. If you can't reach the mat, push into your legs. And you should really be feeling this through the left IT band there, IT band area. One more breath here. All right, everybody, inhale tall through their spine, and you're gonna exhale and crawl to the other side. So Judy, you're here on your blocks. Anna and I are holding on to our legs or down at the mat, whichever works best for you. And now I'm feeling that all through the right side. We have three more breaths here. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, come back to center, and you can inhale, drop out to the sides and all the way up to the top. And exhale, hands to the heart. And we'll switch legs. Shake that out before you go into the other side. Okay, so this time, left leg crosses in front. And we'll take a deep inhale, tall, and exhale, sliding down as far as we can go, either coming to the blocks or to our shins or to the mat. And we breathe. Once again, don't squeeze your shoulders up. Open them up and leave space around your ears. Three more breaths here. Deep inhale. Exhale, walk over to the left. Two more breaths. Deep inhale. Exhale, crawl all the way over to the right and breathe. Two more breaths. Deep inhale. Exhale back to center. And inhale all the way out and up. And exhale straight down the center to the heart. And uncross, shake that out. Okay, a little bit of balance before you got a bamboo, say A-H, A-H-S. I don't know where I got A, whatever. A-H-S. All right, so I'll show you this one from the side. Hopefully I won't fall, but you know, it's likely that I may, because it's a balanced posture. So let me remind you about balance. It is absolutely necessary, especially when you're doing standing balance, that you find a drishti, one point to focus, laser focus your gaze on it. Don't let it waver from that one point. Because if the eyes are wandering, the mind is wandering. And if the mind is wandering, the body cannot balance. So you're going to need to find a drishti. And you want to have the feeling whenever you're doing a standing balance posture that everything is drawing into center and lifting up. So you don't want to be collapsed. You want to be good and engaged and lengthened up, and that will help you draw in and up and maintain your balance. So we're going to start with the right leg being the working leg and our left leg being our standing leg. So we're just going to test the waters with knee to chest posture. So what I'd like for you to do is inhale and draw your right knee forward and up into your chest and take hold. Now, you'll notice I've got my toes flexed and flared. That's bringing awareness all the way through the tips of my toes. I'm not hunched over. I've got my shoulders back and my chest open, and I'm pressing firmly through my standing leg without locking my standing leg knee. There's a micro bend in it, and I'm taking the wobble in my ankle. There is going to be wobble. That's just how it is. So don't feel like you're doing it wrong if you're wobbling, but you do want to be able to take the wobble in the ankle, in that standing leg. And release down. Shake that out. And you can give some ankle circles with that left standing ankle. Make sure you go both ways. Okay, we'll give it a go on the other side. So I'll switch directions here so that you can see the leg that's working. So this time the right leg is going to be our standing leg and the left leg is going to be our working leg. Find your drishti. find the four corners of the standing leg foot. I didn't cue this on the other side, but the inner and outer ball and the inner and outer heel. You can lift your toes and spread them, and that'll identify those four points very quickly for you. That's what you want to ground down into. So you're pressing into those points so that you can rise up out of it and have a good, strong standing leg there. All right, so strong standing right leg. Find your wrist deep, and then you're going to inhale and draw the left knee in and up to your chest and take hold. This is basically standing up in asana. We do it on our backs oftentimes. Same posture, just a different orientation to gravity. A little more challenging than when we're on our backs. Don't forget to flex and flare your working leg foot or toes. That'll help with your awareness, and it will help with your balance. Finding the balance between effort and ease. Make sure you're not clenching your teeth or squeezing your shoulders. Make sure the heart is lifted. Taking an inhale. Exhale, release down. Roll your standing right ankle out. Both ways. Okay, Anna, it's 7 o'clock. If you need to go, feel free. We are going to do one more standing balance on each side. Okay, so I'm going to go back to my right leg being the working leg here. Left leg is going to be my standing. I am going to lift forward and up like I just did, except this time I'm going to stop at hip height. So, go ahead and find your dristy. Find the groundedness in your standing leg. And you're going to inhale and lift the knee forward and up. I've got flexed and flared toes. I'm going to sweep across with my left hand to take hold of the outside of my right thigh. And then I'm going to pull in on that thigh with the hand, but push the thigh back into the hand. Double resistance there. You'll feel it engage your side body. And then I'm going to inhale and open my arm back. And if I'm very daring, I'm going to try to cast my gaze over my back arm. Ooh, this is where I'm probably going to fall. And we breathe. One more breath. And then I try to, I'm gonna lose it. Oh, I was about to say, I'm gonna try to come back out of it with as much control as I went into it, but that did not happen for me. So, I know it's hard to believe, and I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I am human. I'm just kidding. No, I'm not kidding. I am human, but I'm kidding about disappointing. All right. So, same thing, other side. So the left leg is going to be the floating leg. Right leg is going to be your standing leg. Find your groundedness. Tailbone reaches toward the heel. Navel draws in and up. Tall and strong before you ever get started. Find your dristy. You're going to inhale and lift the knee up hip height. You'll sweep across with the right hand to the outside of the thigh. Press the thigh into the hand. Pull back in against that with the hand. Double resistance there. Open out with your arm, and then very slowly try to cast your gaze, if you want, over your back arm. And we breathe. No, I'm losing it. like a difficult posture, but it is. Two more breaths. And try to come back. And release. I lost it like two or three times on that one. Y'all probably did better than I did on that one. All right. Okay, we can do this next one without blocks as well. Judy, go ahead and grab your blocks and you're gonna bring them to the top of your mat. Hands to the hips. Inhaling tall through the crown of the head. Exhale, bend into your knees and step back through your right leg. You're going to bring about a 10 or 15 degree swivel in of the back heel. So that, don't overdo it. Don't swing really far, like 90 degrees. You don't want to draw that heel in too much because the act of swiveling the heel externally rotates this hip. But we're going to internally rotate against that. And you want to look at your feet and make sure you're on train tracks, not a balance beam. If you're on a balance beam, it's going to be very difficult to hold your balance for this posture. So my right leg is back. The swivel of the heel, it puts my back toes roughly pointing toward the top corner of my mat. That's how little swivel is in the back heel. And actually, if that is yucky on your knee, you can have all 10 toes forward. A lot of folks do these internally rotated hip position standing postures with both feet straight on because the knee just does not like that wrap against it. So please modify however your body is telling you to. So I'm in pyramid pose with my legs, just for reference purpose. And I wanna wrap the back thigh in toward my navel to square my hips off to the front of my mat. I'll show y'all that from the front. So, this is what it looks like. So I'm on train tracks. Let me back up some. I'm on train tracks instead of a balance beam. I'm on train tracks. And when I swivel that back heel, this hip wants to go with it. I want to wrap my back thigh in toward my navel to square my hips off to the front of the room or to the front of my mat. Okay? From here, you're going to bring your left hand, that's your front foot, you're going to bring your left hand to your left hip. You're going to inhale out and up with the right, and exhale, come across to the outside of your left thigh. So I hinged at my hips a little bit to get there. I'm going to take a deep inhale long through my spine, and I'm going to exhale and slide down my leg, and I can either land at my block, crossing over my leg with my block to the outside of my ankle, or I can just stay on my leg. And then when you get there, you want to try to stack your shoulders. So let me show you this from the other angle, the other side. So this is, I'm on the same side, just turn around so you can see it from that side. So I start here, nice and tall, sweep across, begin hinging to fold forward, and I can either land on my block or on my leg, and then I want to work. I push this hand into my leg, or I push down into my block and try to stack my shoulders. This is revolve trine, and it should be lining up the IT band on the front leg. Two more reps. And it's just as difficult to come back up because it's a balancing act. Back up to center, bend into your front knee, and launch your back foot forward. Ooh, that's a doozy. Thumbs up if y'all are all right. Awesome. Shaking that out, shaking that out. We got the other side to go, and then we're coming down to our backs.
Yay!
Good work tonight, ladies. All right, so I'll start, let's see, so that was that leg forward. I'll start for this side of my mat, and then I'll flip around again so that you can see it from both sides. Okay, so top of the mat to you. Hands to the hips to begin with. Deep inhale, tall through the crown of the head. Exhale, soft bend, stepping back with the left leg this time. Straightening through the front leg. You're gonna give that small swivel inward with the back heel, if that's appropriate for your knee. And then you're going to wrap your back hip, or sorry, back thigh in towards your navel to square your hips off to the front of your mat. So we're here. Back thigh is engaged, back leg is fully engaged, really. We're gonna inhale out and up with the left arm. And exhale across to the outside of the right thigh. Then we're gonna inhale tall, and then we're gonna exhale and start hinging at the hips to slide down the leg. And we're either gonna land in our block or just land somewhere near our calf. And then we're gonna try to start stacking the shoulders. So I'll show you what that looks like from the other side. I slide, and then I press with this bottom hand into my calf or into my block to help me start opening and stacking the shoulders as I fall. It's a toughie. Two more breaths. And then I inhale and unwind. And come all the way up, bend into the front knee, and launch my back foot forward. Now can you shake it out? Nice. Go ahead and you've earned the right just to plop down on your back. We're gonna twist it out to each side, and then twill be time for a little bit of Shavasana. And then I think it's cocktail hour after this, right? No! Judy, I know. Y'all go ahead and come down onto your back. I've got a whole mint bed out there that's calling my name for mint juleps. All right. So we'll just start with both knees bent. And I want you to press into your feet to lift your hips. Shift them over to the right side of your mat. So you're gonna feel weird because your shoulders and your feet are in center, but your hips are over to the right. And this is just to help line our spine up once we twist. You're gonna cross your right leg over your left. Fully, knee over knee, ladylike style. You can hook your foot behind the calf if that's accessible to you. If it's not, don't worry. It's not a necessity of the pose. You're going to come out to a T with your arms, or you can come to goalposts. And on the exhale, you're going to let your knees fall across your body to the left. And if you get a pop in your low back, you owe me an Aldi cart quarter. Anna, I think it used to be a nickel when you were in town and one of my students, and you know, inflation. I'm having to charge an Aldi cart quarter for each pop. You know, cracking lame jokes isn't quite as fun when there's nobody to give me courtesy laughs in the room. I at least get something out of a courtesy laugh. Some sort of satisfaction. I can hear you laughing in your hearts. Few more breaths here. And we'll go ahead and inhale up to center, unwind, uncross, and then we'll lift our hips and shift them all the way over to the left side of our mat, cross our left leg over our right, you can hook if you'd like, and then on an exhale, let your knees fall across your body to the right. To Shavasana. I'm just gonna cut the lights here, make it feel a little more Shavasana-y. Whisper. It's okay to release. Letting go, my body says back to me, thank you. Letting go, I find a silence and a stillness so sweet. Letting go, I feel my body welcome in peace. This feeling of centeredness, groundedness, and ease, a becomes available anytime I'm willing to let go and welcome and release. As the sound of the bell enters into your awareness, let it bring with it an awareness of your surroundings. Beginning to deepen your breath and turn your senses outward once again. Slowly begin to bring movements back into your body, starting with fingertips and toes, hands and feet, wrists and ankles, arms and legs. Whole body making movements that feel good to you. And when you're ready, make your way over onto your right side using your arm as a pillow. Remaining there for just a couple of breaths, allowing all weight off the heart. And then you can gently help yourself back up to a comfortable seated position. We'll end where we began. I invoke favor, peace, prosperity, and health upon each of us this evening. May we experience full restoration, nothing missing, nothing broken. That which has been taken from us, physical and not, may be returned to us sevenfold. And that which was once broken in our lives, bodies, minds, or spirits, may it be mended like new. May all beings be happy, healthy, and free, and may we practice with patience and know much peace. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining me this evening, ladies. Giving me a little bit of something to feed off of recording this session. And everyone that accesses the recording, thanks you as well for giving me a little bit of an audience here tonight. Namaste, friends. Be well.